Hello, so we are back with our first set of knowledge series. This is Know Your Roots, Banh Mi and Bandej. So what we have over here is assorted types of banh mi ware. First, Kavita, say hi. Okay, so Kavita is going to show us a close-up view of what this banh mi is like. So as banh mi, the name suggests, it is basically a tie and dye technique. And if you see closely, these things have been tied together and then dyed. So each of these small tiny dots is then released by removing the thread, and the output is this type of a beautiful dyed dot. So these dots can vary in shapes and sizes, and we've got something that is as tiny as a mustard seed, that's called as Rai Bandhej, and you've got the larger ones also. So some of the popular forms of tie and dye techniques are Leheria. This is basically lines, right? And the width of the line can vary. We've also got Shibori and others, but today we're talking all about banh mi. So first and foremost, let's see how banh mi has been fusioned with this beautiful khatli work. This one is a suit piece where we've got the top, which is on cotton, and it has this amazing hand-done khatli work, which again finds its origin from Gujarat. And we've got the top and the bottom, which is banh mi. Okay, and banh mi, this one is done on cotton. And one important fact that you need to understand is that when you actually roll press this, that's when at least 2 to 3 inches increase in the actual dimensions of the fabric. They shrink when they are tied together, and when it's released, that's when it actually takes its original size and form. Let's see some new nice designs in different types of banh mi. So we've got this. Now, banh mi is a tie and dye technique, but you can also have industrial banh mi done, wherein it's basically just cream printed. This one is a beautiful kutch work with pearls. This is the top, this is a kurta, and the bottom is printed banh mi with a printed banh mi dupatta. So basically, these motifs are the usual banh mi ones, but this is not being tied and dyed. So this is where we want to show the difference between an actual tie and dye original banh mi and printed banh mi. This one is one of our best sellers. It's on Dupion silk. Dupion silk, Banarasi woven design. Okay, and in the middle, they have, the karigars have nicely done some nice bandage work. Yep. So in banh mi, you will often see some unevenness and some sort of coloration in certain sides. Now this particular thaan would have come in a pure white, and then which would have been a Banarasi woven thaan, and then it would have been dyed in these different colors, the brick red, the greenish aqua green color, and after that the karigars would have done the bandage work where they've tied this. So this has been roll pressed now, but you can still see how it has been tied, and that's why there are some wrinkles. Now we're going to show you another fusion work, how banh mi has been done with ajrak. Now ajrak again is a hand block printing technique, but the use of natural dyes is what makes this piece really good. This is on modal silk, hence the shine, and this part is the banh mi part. So it takes equal amount of efforts, because again, this part is being dyed separately, this part is being dyed separately. This is an entirely different technique, which is bandhani, and that is an entirely different technique, which is called as ajrak. So the karigars have to be very, very careful, because there can be always splashes of colors from either sides that can actually damage the sari. And hence, on this side, if you see, there are some nice orangish or brownish patches, which is actually because of the ajrak dyes, right? So these kind of imperfections and irregularities is what you will always find when we are doing any kind of fusion tie and dye or hand block prints. Next, let's see how bandhage looks on a purer fabric. So this one is again a Banarasi handloom jagla. So there's a complete jal of zari, and what has been done is then dyeing, and then you've got these much finer bandhage work all over. And here there are two different colors that have been used. One is yellow and one is white. So this is on pure georgette fabric, hence it's quite lightweight, right? And it's a very flowy fabric. Kavita, can we actually see the entire thing, right? So that everybody knows what it is. So two tones, one is red and one is pink, that has been used, right? And the Banarasi weave, which is of a beautiful golden zari. And then we've got the white as well as the red spots. So that is what is this sari all about. It's basically a fusion of different designs, different patterns and different techniques. And that's why it's a piece of art, and it looks really, really beautiful. So we've got various colors in this, but this series is all about actually improving your knowledge about it. Next, we'll see a dupatta. Now, some of you might be familiar with something called as kharchola. Now, these are the checks that are often a part of the kharchola design. And there is the bandhani, which is in the center of these checks. Right? So this one is a silk dupatta with these checks in zari. That's the back side. Okay. And now this one is again a bandhani dupatta on art silk. So the reason why we want to show you is there are different types of fabrics that can be used, and depending on the fabrics, the pricing varies. Now this one is an art silk, and if you see closely, because obviously these are tied, and a lot of the times art silk actually leaves certain tiny holes. So over a period of time, the georgettes or the modal silks will never kind of lose the color. The fabric will remain really nice, but art silks obviously tend to get damaged more easily, but they are very pocket friendly in terms of pricing. And it will give you as much shine. So that's the actual bandhani, and this is the reverse side. Now this one again is a dupatta, but on pure georgette fabric. Again, two different colors have been used, the magenta and the blue, and you've got the Banarasi weave. But this one is not a handloom Banarasi. That's why you'll again find a difference in the pricing. And then the bandhage has been done in the center. So this one has not been roll pressed. That's why you would see that the width will turn out to be slightly shorter than what it actually is. Once it's roll pressed, it will flatten out and it will gain its normal shape and size. And lastly, we have a cotton one. This is a cotton bandhani sari that we have over here. Again, double shaded. So what you need to understand is that
these colors are obviously industrial colors, unlike the ajraks, which are natural dyes. So the chances of this bleeding is usually high, but if bandage has been practiced properly and it has been dried to the right extent and the fabric starch was removed properly before dyeing, then it will not bleed as such. A little bleeding is always possible. So these are again pocket friendly, very cooling kind of saris in bantni, bright colors, and they have this type of a woven border. So we've got lots more on our website fulari.com, but this was just to improve your knowledge and to know your roots about bandhni bandhej. Signing off, bye bye.